What's up, guys? Sean Nalawani here, seannal.com, bodytransformationtruth.com, and today's question is, do squats and deadlifts increase testosterone levels? The idea here being that because squats and deadlifts are such challenging movements, and because they train so many large muscle groups at the same time, that performing them is going to significantly boost your overall testosterone and growth hormone levels, and that that's going to help you build more muscle throughout your entire body as a result, in comparison to not having them in your plan. You've probably heard the idea that doing squats will help you build bigger biceps, and that's where this sort of old school idea comes from. So what's the truth here? The way I would sum it up is like this. Yes, heavy resistance training does increase testosterone levels, and bigger, more challenging compound exercises do increase testosterone levels to a larger degree than smaller, less challenging isolation exercises. However, the hormonal increases that you get from this are only short, temporary spikes that go back to baseline fairly quickly. And because of that, it doesn't necessarily mean that those increases are actually going to carry over and give you a noticeable improvement in bottom line muscle growth. The key thing to understand is that in order for testosterone levels to significantly affect your size and strength gains, those levels have to be elevated by a large percentage and then sustained over a prolonged period of time. So even if a barbell squat might give you a bigger temporary increase in testosterone than a leg press, and the research actually shows that it does, that doesn't automatically mean that those hormonal effects are actually going to help you build more muscle from it. And there actually have been several studies on this, looking at how certain exercises or training protocols affect hormone levels and whether that translates to greater gains in size and strength. And when you look at the data, that's basically what you see. You either see that the increase in hormone levels has no direct effect on muscle growth at all, or you see some minor effects, but that the correlation is very weak. I won't go into the details on all of that, but I'll link the main studies in the description box if you do want to check them out. So in terms of practical recommendations, I just don't think this whole question of do squats increase testosterone or do deadlifts increase testosterone, it's just not something that has any real direct use for you. So if you're someone who can't perform squats or deadlifts, then I don't think you're missing out on anything important from a hormonal perspective. And if you are performing them, I wouldn't go out of my way to do them more often or with more volume just for the sake of trying to increase your testosterone levels higher. I mean, it's possible that if you were a high-level bodybuilder trying to squeeze out every possible ounce of muscle growth that you could, it's possible that all those little temporary spikes in testosterone from doing deadlifts versus not doing deadlifts, maybe they would add up over the course of 5 years and help you gain an extra tenth of a pound of muscle. I mean, I obviously can't say what the effects would be, if anything, but for the average lifter, it's just not something to worry about. It's analogous to like taking a piss in the ocean, basically, where even if there is an effect, it's likely so small that you probably wouldn't even notice it. I think it's pretty safe to say, based on the research, that muscle growth is primarily a localized event that happens at the level of the specific muscles that you're directly training. And anecdotally, you can look at guys who have huge ripped upper bodies who don't even train legs, just to see an example of that. And I think that trying to structure your training program around the specific goal of manipulating testosterone or growth hormone levels, that's just not going to be a good use of your effort. And it could actually be counterproductive if it takes your focus away from maintaining a properly balanced program in terms of exercise layouts and volume and frequency. My advice is to just put all your focus on maximizing your overall progression in the gym and maintaining a properly balanced program, and then just let the hormonal aspect take care of itself. So thanks for watching, guys, and if you do want to grab a complete step-by-step science-based plan that will help you accomplish that as effectively as possible, the workouts, the meal plans, the supplement guides, along with one-on-one coaching, then you can download my body transformation blueprint by clicking here or by heading over to bodytransformationtruth.com using the link in the description box. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did enjoy the video, as always, make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. You can also check out my official blog over at seannal.com for all of my latest updates. And you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat here if you aren't already. The links for that are also in the description box. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll talk to you again soon.